Greetings dear friends, I present to your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the Mitsubishi Carisma. Mitsubishi Carisma is a simple car, only front-wheel drive, no ultra-modern gearboxes. The choice is only between the mechanics and the automatic. Moreover, there are not many automatic transmissions in the population, and this is bad. Manual transmissions on Carisma are problematic, and automatic are from very reliable series. True unsuccessful manual transmissions are not found on all cars, but on most cars they are still not encouraging. Choosing a car on mechanics and with the 1.6-liter engine, you agree in advance that there will be no clarity of gear shifting, but the resource of synchronizers, shafts and gearbox bearings will be low, and leaks and damage to all seals will follow almost on every MOT. A quiet thank you should be said to Renault, which in cooperation with Volvo supplied GB3 series transmission to this plant. Moreover, exactly the same problems with boxes haunted the last generation of Volvo, 440, 460. True, then everything was even a little worse and the rear box passed 800,000 without problems. And on Carisma and S40 boxes with a quick, but sometimes they live up to 250 or more thousand kilometers without serious breakdowns. And then the endless repair begins. The reason lies in the interesting design of the J3 box. In principle, it is well known to all owners of Logan, but modern versions are much stronger and lack problems on travels. The fact is that for sake of obtaining an equal length of the semi-axles of this box, the left semi-shaft goes directly into the box to the differential. There inside, in the old bed of the box itself, a tripod is installed. On the shaft itself there is a bearing to which the boot seal of the box is attached. While everything is new, nothing terrible happens, but over time the enters begin to leak. And because of the unreliable fixation of the tripod inside, it often pulls out. There are many reasons for this. Impacts, tired front suspension, violation of the body geometry or wear of the tripod glass. At the same time, oil is immediately poured out of the box. And if the car is still moving under its power, or it is being towed for a long time and quickly, then there will be nothing to repair. And if the CV joint flew once, then it will be fly regularly. But this is only half or even a third of the trouble. Little bearing of a tripod, of which there are three, collapse much more often. In the event of a brake failure, the needles from the particular hard alloy fall into the inside of the manual transmission and safely destroy absolutely everything. When replacing the drive, you need to be careful, the needles may fall out at this very moment. If it seems to you that these problems are not enough, then there is another. With high mileage, the secondary shaft breaks in half. They solve problems in different ways. Someone is trying to fix the tripod with a special plate on the differential, usually unsuccessfully. Someone is trying to install new shafts and starting out the tripods. Unfortunately, only the complete drive is used for spare parts from Mitsubishi, and it is an extremely strange act to pay 20,000 rubles for a part for a car with a price of 100. But what about Renault, you say? After all, there are the same boxes, maybe the spare parts will fit? Officially, no, you can't find anything by codes. You need a tripod for the stars with 29 teeth and 23mm, for example, Vima 764 or Coram 6027 will do. The price is less than 1,000 rubles, and the chances of wreckage with the new part are significantly reduced. And the tripod glass itself, which is also often worn out, which causes strong vibrations, is also picked up from a Renault. Unfortunately, most of the car owners do not even think about such collective farming, and the services simply shrug their shoulders. They say the French have done junk, and they are not to blame. Although by replacing literally two details, you can get rid of problems for many years and not wait for surprises every day. Another problem with the manual transmission, which is present on all cars with engines up to 1.6 liters, is the looseness of the gearbox drive. It is made here by traction, and over time, the clarity of the switching disappears. So much so the killed gearbox's drive on the VIZ2110-2 will seem to be to you almost standard. Well, again, there are no small parts on sale, so the lever rocker and the shift mechanism are usually replaced with the used assemblies, and new parts are indecently expensive. With engines of 1.8 liters, there is a completely different box, well known from other cars, Mitsubishi FMM, F5M42 and several versions. It is more reliable with a cable drive, which, if it loosens over the years, is much less, and kidification can be easily eliminated by replacing the cables or at least lubricating them. Occasionally, desperate owners of cars with a GB3 box change the box to an F5M42. It's not that easy, you need to digest the attachments on the subframe, put in the new flywheel and clutch, new engine mounts, drive gear, rocker and a lot of rather little things. But a box as a whole is much more reliable, and besides there are a lot of contracts unit on the market. Automatic transmissions of the F4A42 series enjoy the well-deserved name of unclickable ones. On Carisma, their resource is often greater than the resource of the machine as a whole. This 4-speed automatic, which is often called INVEX 2, with careful maintenance and careful handling, can cover more than 300 km. Weaknesses, of course, are, but mostly they manifest themselves on more powerful engines that are available on Carisma, especially since she got a reinforced version of the box, which was installed almost on 3-liter engines. It works perfectly with the 1.6 and 1.8-liter engines. All major breakdowns are associated either with engine of the wiring or with wear of the solenoids. Mechanical failures and clutch wear are rare and occur due to poor quality maintenance, overheating, missed oil level or extreme wear of the gas turbine engine blocking linings, and sharp oil contamination. The range of motors for this model is not too large. The choice was offered only by 1.3-liter 4G13 SOHC 16-valve engine, with which installed throughout the entire production period several versions of the 1.6-liter 4G92 SOHC 16 engine, differing in power and control system, as well as the 1.8-liter 4G93 engine in SOHC and the OHC GDI. In addition to gasoline engines, diesel engines were also offered, without which there was nothing to do in Europe. But these motors were purchased Renault designs. Before the restyling, the vulnerable 1.9-liter F8 QT single-shaft and 8-valve SOHC8, if we follow the system of designation of engine option familiar to every Mitsu owner, was installed. This pre-chamber turbo diesels with a high-power pressure fuel pump and electronic adjustment of the injection moment produced as much as 90 horses, which is almost a record for such a power system. The motor can be both found on Volvo and on half of the French car in the 80s and 90s, but at Carisma in Russia it is rare. After restyling, the car received a much more modern F9 Q1 engine with a downstream turbine, torque shaft and common rail. It was installed in various versions on Renault cars until 2012, and on the European Grand Vitara even up to 2015. In general, this is a more successful engine, but at Carisma again it is very rare. All motors except for the very rare 4J93 SOHC 16-valve have two versions. Before and after restyling, the control system differs for the Euro 2 and the Euro 3 Eco standards, respectively. Later engines have slightly more electronics, more delicate and expensive catalysts. They have many small updates on the mechanical part, but in general they do not have any major differences on operation. Basically everything is the same, but a little newer and with more expensive attachments. Do not be pleased with the presence of the same motors on Japanese cars. They and the European motors often do not have even compatible blocks, not to mention attachments. Selecting a contract motor from a Japanese car is not an easy task at all. However, there are English clubs or Carisma owners where she even had her own fans, so I recommend looking on co.uk sites. There is a lot of information on replacements, tuning and other improvement and farming, or what is collective farming in English. There is a lot, and if you want to try on 4G63 in this car and put all-wheel drive, however, this will not work for our swappers either, just the quality of the result may not be pleased. With other motors in addition, the car gets a weak engine compartment wiring and an average quality cooling system. Global and unsolvable problems are not foreseen here, but look around carefully. Sometimes it's amazing how the motors manage to work and moreover reliably with such a state of attachments. The quality of the layout of the engine compartment is almost standard. Everything is surprisingly convenient, so that all problems are immediately visible. The smallest 1.3-liter motors belong to the Orion 4G1 series and unfortunately cannot boast of either power or resource, and the economy with them is also questionable. At first you will only need to change the belt, adjust the valves and repair the ignition system in time. So the motor will live up to 150,000 km, but then it will gradually begin to eat oil. Actually, there are no more cars with such a low mileage, so the propensity of oil appetite is mainly determined by how long overhaul was done in the replacement of the piston group. The motor is often replaced with a related contract 4G15, 4G18, which are cheaper than low-volume European motors. Two of the cars that have understandable problems with documents. In addition, large volume motors of this series are also not very pleasing with the resource and suffer from an increased oil appetite. It is better to refuse Carisma with a 1.3-liter engine unless it has an absolutely perfect body, because the Berlin 4G92 is next in the line for engines. The mid-sized block of the 4G9 series turned out to be successful. Unlike the Lancer 4G18, it doesn't eat oil after 120-150,000 mileage, is easy to repair, has sufficient traction for this car, and with minimal maintenance and serviceability, or simply lack of catalyst, it can pass 300,000 more kilometers, which is just an excellent result for such a structure. In addition, there is a conventional injection, so if failures occur, it's only if drunk school children were repairing the car strictly on Fridays. All other types of service are tolerable by the engine, although the resource from the beyond may become limited. but still more than sufficient for everyday use. Even if the belt breaks, the valves on the SOHC 16 valve version rarely fold. So this is an almost ideal engine for people with reduced car reliability. All updates closer to 300,000 mileage gradually manifest itself, but it is often treated. Even if the belt breaks, the valves on the SOHC 16 valve versions rarely fold. So this is an almost ideal engine for people with reduced car reliability. All updates closer to 300,000 mileage gradually manifest itself, but it is often treated even without worrying with new horn and stock pistons of the last size group. Surprisingly low wear for such runs. The motor historically transfers experiments on Chinese parts, but you shouldn't abuse it either. The most powerful engines on Carisma are the 1.8-liter engines of the 4G93 series. Until 1997, the cars were equipped with the fairly reliable versions of the SOHC engine with conventional injection or a sports DOHC version for as much as 140 horsepower on MXE models. But after 1997, the company introduced direct injection and therefore all restyled and late restyling cars with 1.8 GDI engines are strongly discouraged for purchase. This is not because GDI is still difficult to understand and the motor will not work normally. Now, direct injection has already become commonplace. They have learned to maintain and diagnose it, to restore expensive high-pressure fuel pumps and injectors. But this all happened in the last 5 years, and before that, GDI was serviced as necessary. And this affects the resource of the motors, and what they could have done there will have to be figured out in practice. Moreover, the 1.8-liter engines turn out to be somewhat more prone to all-uptime than the structurally similar 1.6-liter ones. With potentially the same resource in practice, these motors often do not live to old age due to the pollution, rapid death of catalysts, failures of the power supply system and detonation, suboptimal operating modes and similar problems. When the oil level drops, they easily and naturally rip up the liners. And besides, the GDI still remains a rather capricious and expensive power system to repair, which doesn't tolerate sloppiness, dirty fuel in the tank, old filters, a clogged tank and engine ventilation system, as well as dusty catalyst. The increased load on the EGR system creates the prerequisites for both its failures and for contamination of the intake manifold with soot and ceramic dust. In general, it's better not to mess with 1.8-liter engines. As a last resort, thoroughly check them upon purchase and in the future be ready to visit specialized services. And this information about the problems of Mitsubishi Carisma is exhausted. If you know more or disagree with what you heard, I'm waiting for you in the comments.